Which cement is best for construction? How do I know what type of cement should be used for construction? How many bags of cement do I need to do a slab of 6 by 7 meters? Which is the best brand of cement? What cement is best? What is the difference between OPC and PVC? This question is there everywhere. All on your core of it, people always want to know about cement. A lot of people keep questioning which brand of cement to use and which is the best type of cement for construction. So, to answer this question broadly, there's a lot of factors to be considered. But I'll try to answer in, you know, with the most simplest of all of these answers. So for that, let's go to site. We are here at our site in Madipakam. This is a 3000 square feet villa that we are building. You know, project is estimated to be complete by sometime around mid of August. There is this common presumption about, you know, there is this common question that everybody asks about cement. When it comes to construction, the most commonly used raw material is cement. So what is cement? What is good cement? Which brand of cement to use? This is a common question. So I am here to answer it all. When it comes to cement, there's only two types of cement you can use. One is the cement you can use and the other is the cement that you cannot use. Cement is the general binding material in concrete, mortar or any other, you know, construction material. So cement, there's one way to specify whether the cement is good to use or not. Here are the few field tests that we do, you know, just to make sure the cement is good condition. First is the date of manufacture. It shouldn't be very old. It shouldn't be, you know, more than 6 months old. This is not something we eat, but it's as important as it. So there's a few things you have to look at it. First off, it has to be fine enough. There shouldn't be any lumps in the cement. Second, when you put your hands inside the cement, it has to be cold. It shouldn't be hot. The reason behind this is because cement, when cement hydrates, it's an exothermic reaction, and there's a lot of heat that comes out of the cement when, you know, water is added to it. So one common way to identify whether the cement is good to use is, you know, just shove your hands into it, and if it's warm, then you just drop the bag, not use it. What type of cement should I use? So people normally ask, you know, this brand is good, you know, just because Sarath Kumar vandu or advertisement la indha brand super ah use pannunga appdin sonnaangalo the Radhika indha TMD nalla irukku appdin sonnaanga na adu nalla irukku artham illa. So there's only two types of cement. The only thing that you should be considered about is, you know, whether you use an OPC 53 or a PPC. If you're looking at any residential construction, I would suggest PPC is more than enough. But based on the structural, you know, that's why engineers are there for. Other than that, every brand is the same. Every brand is the same. Amma brand kuda use pannalam. How to make strong concrete? That's a totally different question. However, that is the actual question you should be asking, because cement is not something you're going to use right away raw, but concrete is something that's going to actually hold your building strong and save your life from not whatever. So how to make a strong concrete is just, you know, in layman terms, if you look at the direct perspective, there's about 20 different things that affect the strength of concrete. However, there's major thing, there's a one, you know, most underrated thing that comes to, you know, concrete strength is the amount of water. The same cement, you know, the same Penna cement that we're using can yield a concrete of strength about 60 megapascal, and the same cement with the same volume can yield a strength of about 30 megapascal, just based on one factor, and that one factor is how much water you add. Yes, did you know that a little bit of extra addition of water would actually cause the cement or the concrete to lose its strength? Yes. But nobody tells you, especially the person who's selling you the cement, he wouldn't tell you. The allowable water content of any concrete is about somewhere between 40 to 50%, which means for a bag of cement, you can maximum pour about 25 liters of water when it's in concrete form. How much do we pour? So done with the cement now. If you look at this side, right now we're doing the basement here. You know, it's again a general assumption that, you know, the, you know, house should be above the road level so that, you know, as years come, our government contractors don't have this habit of drilling the existing roads, which is also called milling the existing roads before laying another road. So eventually the road keeps getting taller and taller every year. So prevent this, we have a very high basement here. It's about 4 feet from ground level or the road level to prevent any future, you know, flood or whatever. So how things start to work when it comes to construction? That's something a lot of people ask me. How do you start with construction? So the very first thing that starts off is, you know, the foundation. That's where everything starts. So to start off with that, before you go into or jump into concrete and columns per se, we first test the soil. Soil is tested for a lot of things that you would find on the internet or, you know, a latest edition of Gopal Ranjan textbook. But let me just stop it with soil testing, followed by which foundation is laid. And on top of that, we have what is here is called the plinth beam, on top of which we do our basement block work that will be filled with earth and eventually filled with flooring level, and from there starts the building. To actually see the superstructure going, we'll have to wait. Patience is the key. We actually wait for a month to actually see this thing come out of the pit till the ground level. So stay tuned. The key to completing any project without any injuries or, you know, labor manpower waste is to provide the labor adequate safety and rest. And for this, welcome to our office, also the Stark Towers for this particular project. This is where the labor stay. So this is where they sleep. There's about 5-6 people who stay here around the clock, because around the clock the job happens, so people have to stay here. Normally our work timings start at about 9 o'clock in the morning, sometimes extend to about 12 in the night, sometimes even throughout the night. We can go to on-site and still stay here.